Welcome back, dear students. So this is our sixth part of the video, how to avoid most common mistakes in math. I hope you have enjoyed the last five videos in the series, and today I have come with another very frequently occurring mistake in math, which I have seen students making while solving problems of math. Okay, so this mistake is related to the topic inverse trigonometry, or you can say inverse trigonometric functions. So suppose I have to find tan inverse 2 plus tan inverse 0.8. Okay, so usually I have seen people doing like this. Tan inverse, we will use the formula. Formula we use is this: tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus x1. Okay, tan inverse is also written as arctan. So first of all, I want to clarify that arctan x is just another symbol for this. Okay, arctan x and tan inverse x are same, and arctan x is becoming more popular in fact now. Okay, but they are same thing. Okay, they mean the same thing. So now we will calculate this. So tan inverse x plus y, 2 plus 0.8 upon 1 minus 2 into 0.8. That becomes tan inverse 2.8 by 1 minus 1.6. Okay, equal to tan inverse 2.8 by 0.4, which becomes minus, okay, tan inverse minus, this becomes 7, minus 7. And tan inverse minus A is minus tan inverse A. We can write minus tan inverse 7. Okay? So this is what usually people do. Okay? Many people take care of this and they solve it correctly. But this one, this solution is incorrect. Okay? This is not correct, and there is a mistake in this. I can first of all explain here what has gone wrong here. Okay, so tan inverse 2 will be a positive number no matter what. Okay, in case you do not know, then I will tell you here that tan inverse x has domain R. Okay, domain is R, and range is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Okay, this is the domain and range of tan inverse x. So tan inverse 2 will be somewhere between 0 to pi by 2. Okay, so it's positive number. Tan inverse 0.8 also will be positive number. So tan inverse 7 is also positive number, but minus tan inverse 7 will become negative number. Okay, so this will be negative number. Okay, you can use calculator also, or you can use any kind of online calculator, okay? But idea is that you will know that tan inverse anything from 0 to infinity will be from 0 to pi by 2, okay? So tan inverse 2 is positive, tan inverse 0.8 is positive, and minus tan inverse 7 will be negative. Now, it's very obvious to understand that sum of two positive numbers cannot be negative. So this is wrong, okay? So many people have a tendency to remember this formula like this, but this is not the right way. The right way is that you remember the formula with conditions. So this formula has actually three parts. One is that tan inverse x plus y by 1 minus xy as it is, okay. Another is tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy plus pi, and the third one is tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy minus pi. Okay, and there are conditions here. The condition is that xy should be positive and xy should be more than 1. Okay, here the condition is xy should be negative and xy should be more than 1. Okay, and this is for all other cases. So this will be actually because 2 and point 8 both are positive, and xy 2 into point 8 is more than 1. You can see 1.6. So the right answer will be, you have to add pi here, plus pi here. So plus pi, and plus pi. Okay? Now this will be somewhere between minus pi by 2 to 0. So the overall number will be positive. So this is the right answer now. Okay? The important thing here is, not only tan inverse x, all the other trigonometric functions will also have many formulas depending on conditions on x, y. Okay? Many books only display the formula for tan inverse x plus tan inverse y like this, but that is the case for all the other trigonometric functions also. Okay? So whenever you are doing sine inverse, cos inverse, you should remember in general that after applying the formula, we have to make sure that the answer is coming within the range of that inverse trigonometric function. For example, you are doing sine inverse. So let's say sine inverse 1 plus sine inverse 1 we are doing, okay, suppose. So sine inverse, popular formula is sine inverse x 1 minus y square under root plus y under root 1 minus x square. Okay? So you get sine inverse x is 1 and y is 1, so 0, because 1 minus y square will become 0, and plus y is 1 and x is 1, so 0 again. So sine inverse 0 and sine inverse 0 is 0. Now please note here, this is how much? Sine inverse 1, which is pi by 2. This is also pi by 2. And you can see that if we apply the formula, without taking care of these conditions, without taking care of various formulas depending on condition on x, y, then this brings us to a contradiction. Pi by 2 plus pi by 2 cannot be 0. Okay? So we have to give the answer within the range. So in this case, it will not be 0, it will be 0 plus pi. So 0 plus pi, and then you have to develop the formula accordingly based on the condition on x, y. So answer will be pi plus this, plus pi, 0 plus pi is equal to pi. Now it is satisfied. The idea is, inverse trigonometric functions have been defined on a certain domain of standard sin x, cos x and tan x functions. So you must know that. That is the underlying concept here. So suppose you talk about sin x. So sine x graph is like this, which is certainly not a 1-1 function, neither 1-2 nor 1-1, okay? So what we have done, while defining sine inverse x, we have taken this portion of graph, this portion of graph, to define sine inverse x. And the domain here is, for this one domain is minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, okay, to 0 to 1. Okay. Similarly, if you talk about cos x, this is sin x. Cos x graph is this, which is again neither 1-1 nor 1-2. So we have defined cos inverse x by taking the 1-1 1-2 part of cos x, which is this one. 0 to pi. 0 to pi, okay? So 0 to pi has been defined as that, okay? So here domain is 0 to pi and range is minus 1 to 1. Okay, so I don't want to go to details of these functions, domain and range. Here I am focusing on the mistakes which people make. So you should make sure that trigonometric functions, sorry, inverse trigonometric functions have been defined on a customized sin x, cos x, tan x function. You must know clearly what is the domain and range. And while giving answers for these kind of questions, you must make sure that the final answer is within the range of that inverse trigonometric function. So for that, we will do this inverse trigonometric function in a separate lecture in future. We will make a video on that, of course. Okay. But right now, please understand that you should not just remember this formula only or this formula only as it is. Okay, you should be careful and you should make sure that the final answer comes in the right domain, right range. Okay, because here pi by 2 plus pi by 2 cannot be 0 if you just apply this formula. Okay, so all these formulas have to be understood very well. Okay, along with the part of the standard graphs, okay, which have been used to define inverse geometric functions. Okay, so I hope you understand this and you won't make this mistake when you are solving math problems. Okay, I will come very soon with the next common mistake made in math. Okay, please subscribe our channel, like our video and share our video, and thank you so much.